my province, for me being a pioneer, no? Slow food has been around for 26 years. It spans across 160 plus countries already. But we're very happy that aside from Slow Food Manila, Slow Food Negros was really a pioneer and a prime mover. Unang ito mo nag-put sa amon sa Slow Food sa 2012. And I think it's also because we as a province, we are very proud of our produce. We are very proud of our cuisine. And at the same time, we know na madamong dito ng products na araganda na nagagubo sa likod sa ating ng mga balay. But if you present it to a global stage, we know that they will think it's exotic, it's wonderful, it's rare. So it's really nice that our province already has a reputation. And I think that kudos and congratulations needs to go to our local government. I'm sure you all agree that our governor, I think even before he became governor, their family was already those that started in Sagay, no? To ensure protecting the environment and making things sustainable. I think they won the Galing Pook Award many, many years ago. So I think that it's really something that's native to us Negrenses. We love our soil, we love our produce, we love our Kasimanwa, because we're proud of what we grow here, and we're a very resilient province. So for that, I'm proud to be your Kasimanwa. Anyway, we all know what slow food is about. Good, clean, and fair food. Good, it has to taste good, and it has to be healthy. Clean, it has to be produced and planted without ruining the environment. And of course, fair, it cannot be very expensive. It needs to be accessible to all of us, and also to all of us, to, you know, the large number of the population. And at the same time, fair, because it needs to give the producer and the farmer the correct price for what he offers the market. So I think, you know, that I don't think that there's been a lack of emphasizing what slow food is all about. But let me share with you another part of slow food, which is what I'm supposed to speak about today. It's called the art of taste. I think all of us know about Noah's Ark, right? Noah's Ark had parang all the animals preserved, you know, whatever was alive at that time, just in case, you know, the big flood would come. And that's really the goal of art of taste, no? Let me just read a little short thing. Parang I don't forget it. Just a little write-up about the art of taste. The art of taste travels the world collecting small-scale quality productions that belong to the cultures, history, and traditions of the entire planet. An extraordinary heritage of fruits, vegetables, animal breeds, cheeses, breads, sweets, and even cured meats. The art was created to point out the existence of these products, draw attention to the risk of their extinction within a few generations, and invite everyone, all of us, to take action to help protect them. In some cases, this might be by buying and consuming the product so that it stays alive and that there's always a market for it. And in some, just by telling the story, in other words, preserving what we've been doing with it for a long time, and supporting the producers and the others, such as the case of endangered wild species. This might mean eating less or more of them in order to preserve them and favor their reproduction. Okay, I think that also to illustrate a little bit more about art of taste, I'd like to show you and share pictures with you of our experience at Slow Food and show you where exactly the art of taste products are displayed. Okay, this is our booth. I think maybe Chip might have shown you some pictures earlier, but I think it's always good. We're a very visual people, so we like to see pictures. This was the Philippine delegation at the booth of Savor Philippines, 7,107 islands. And let me take this opportunity to thank, of course, the Department of Agriculture and the person of Yusef Bernabuya. She loves Negro. She was here with you 2 days ago. And because of her initiative, the Philippines has a great presence now at Slow Food. In 2012, we started, and in 2014 also. So what's great about our booth compared to all the other countries that are in Slow Food, no? It's a big hall in the international arena, and we are one of the few booths that has a kitchen. So that's why they make me put there, so that we can cook and we can make them taste. Because I think touching the product, seeing it, I think it's only half the battle. We need to make them taste how great our products are. So the kitchen idea was really pushed by Yusef Perna, so that we chefs can also show how the products are used. So as you can see there, these are the tickets of the fair. We had some of our brothers from the Cordilleras who came with us and who put on their beautiful costumes. And because of them, we were also the most popular booth because they would dance and they would beat their gongs. And our booth was the happiest, actually. And rightfully so, because we Pinoys are known for the dancing, the singing, and all of that. So it really happened in our booth every day. So those are the tickets again. And this is the exhibition hall in Torino where Salone del Gusto happens. That was us buying in the market so that we would have something to cook with. And we used some Italian produce to go with what we brought to be able to showcase how it can be used abroad. So that's Chef Noel de la Lama, who's also your Casamanua. He lives in New York, but he came with us. And he also helped cook the produce that we brought with us. More pictures of the booth. And Noel shopping. Some more. And there, that was our bulalo that was boiling. Then, of course, the rices in our booth that were displayed, the beautiful heirloom rices from the Cordillera that Amy spoke about so nicely earlier. And then, of course, the fruit wines that we brought along with us, apart from the coffee and the chocolate also. So there, we have a kitchen, so we're there boiling the produce. We're boiling the meat. Little more action shots in the kitchen. And before, you know, the Cordillera panyo with the shells hanging in the neck, just to show our pata pinoy. So we had some of the white corn there, which we put in the bulalo. Then that's native to the Visayas. The white corn is an art of taste product. Actually, we have 32 products from the Philippines, and I'll tell you a little bit about the others, but the ones from Negros, we have Atay, which is Puyas here. It grows in other parts of the Philippines, but it's from Negros also. It's a nice old grain. It's also called Job's Ears and Chinese Barley. Of course, our Ibak, the Tamyas, is also an art of taste product. Our Batuan, which is our souring agent, started to really sort of become prominent thanks to all of us Negrenses for always using it. Aside from that, of course, like I said earlier, the white corn, and hopefully we can get other products from Negros to be included. So we have Vicky Garcia there, Vicky Perna, and the other ladies from the Cordillera who bring the rices, and actually they've been doing it for already 6 years at Salone del Gusto. 2010. Our Silig Labuyo is also a art of taste product. I think we made an achara out of it. Then, of course, the cacao. And that's than some of the red rice that we cooked and made them taste. More action shots. Of course, we bore the Philippine flag proudly. This is the former ambassador from Italy to the Philippines, Luca Fornari, and his wife Silvana, who have been to Negros twice. And up to this day, even if he's no longer in office, he still promotes Negros and the Philippines all the way in Rome. And as you can see, the signage of Casa Artusi, that's a school that I'm starting, is a franchise from Italy. And what's great about it is I'm supposed to promote not only Italian culture and products, but at the same time, best practices in the kitchen, which redounds to any kind of cuisine. So every time I visit Casa Artusi, I do not cook Italian food. I cook Pinoy food and Negrense food when we're there. So it's a great exchange of cultures and a good venue for us to be able to promote our products and our cuisine. More of the bulalo. Actually, it was fancy because we put batuan in it the first time we did it. And as you can see, we even brought our palayoks there so that we can show them how our heritage cuisine is and how slow cooking in an earthen pot makes the difference. And this pot in particular, I carry, and it was given to me by Dr. Joe from here, Dr. Albert Joe. So, again, another product from Negros. And really, it cooks beautifully because he says that his palayok has no lead content. So it's a clean pot. More people from the Department of Agriculture were there to support us. And the Italian contingent from the fair that helped us fall in love with our food. That's, of course, our cajos that you will see later on, that one of the most important personalities from all over the world, who is the one who promoted really slow food and doing things the old-fashioned way, Miss Alice Waters from California. So you will see that the dish that she tasted, the one dish that she tasted in our booth is from Negros. She had the cajos with bamboo. So we have some pictures of her there. There's Noel and the chef from Casa Artusi, Chef Parda. More of the corn. And of course, we brought our Philippine mango. It's repeating again. Towards the end, there's the entertainment that kept our booth busy. And the dancing too. So after a while, everybody was dancing with us. So just a few more pictures. Also, the beautiful town of Torino, where they're known for their coffee and their chocolate. So one day, we hope that they can use our coffee and our chocolate to make their wonderful desserts there. That's the daughter of Secretary Berna, Yusek Berna, who writes very well about slow food. I think she's one of the first to write an article about slow food in the bulletin. And of course, the Philippine cooking contingent posing in Torino, proudly representing all of you. Mentioned from Negros. So there are 32 products from the Philippines, okay? So we have, of course, the adlay or the puyas, ayusip, which is a wild berry. Oh, and there's Jamie Oliver. Of course, he was there to speak together with Alice Waters. And we Filipinos are always starstruck, so we hunted him down to try to get a picture with him. And they actually had a beautiful talk about teaching the world how to cook better and how to plant better. And it was very informative, and at least people like him can help promote the cause. No? You need rock star chefs like him to be able to promote the cause with a greater number of people. So it was good that he was there. Then, of course, coffee beans. Half. Looks like peanuts now. These were brought actually by Bea Misa and her husband Robbie. And this is the art of taste now. So I want you to see where it's displayed. And we're very proud because we took pictures of our products that appear there. And that's the kajos and the adobo that we were making. This was the session with Miss Alice Waters on the left, Jamie Oliver, another gentleman who's also an author, and at the same time, of course, Mr. Carlo Petrini, who is the founder of Slow Food. You'll see him later. That's him. He always visits our booth every time. And I'm sure Chip showed you pictures of him in Korea. And I think that they had a lengthy conversation about what else we can present for the art of taste. So that's what we can go through at the end of my talk. And of course, Mr. Petrini is like a hero to everyone. So this is some of the food that we prepared. We made some caldereta of beef, and we used, of course, the silid labuyo of the Philippines to highlight in the dish. Then we made an achara using Italian tomatoes, but using our seaweed also and some garlic and our vinegar. Now we brought some tubak vinegar, and I have to say that this was the best seller in the booth. People were just eating this and red rice. And we just kept making it continuously because, of course, with the sauce, we can just keep adding the vegetables and it'll continue to pickle. So for 3 days, we preserved the achara and actually just kept getting better and better. And this is, I think, another gentleman from Slow Food who also was very active visiting our booth. By the time the fair ended, we had nothing left in our shelves because everybody wanted to buy what we had to sell. So there's the katyos. It was a little bit malandos pa, but Alice Waters ate it anyway. Then of course, sampling of the rices from the Cordillera. Then red rice and caldereta. We were able to get some banana leaves there. We're almost done with the pictures. We bought it in the Oriental Market. Yeah. And these palayoks we carried actually from Caliga. They're handmade by the women of Caliga. And I've already left them in Italy, so every time we're there, we don't need to care anymore. So, let me just continue with the list and then we can. No, not treated them. We brought them because when you buy them in Caliga, they're already seasoned. And if you notice, there are some etchings on the rim. And those are all personalized etchings of the woman that made the pot. Sometimes they even sign it. So it's great because they give it to you that they're already used. So it's really been seasoned. And we just packed it very carefully. And I think that because it's seasoned, it withstood the cold weather. So again, the patwan, wood kapul is also, I know it's a different name in Dumaguete, siguro. It's also wood. Okay. Then, of course, all the Cordillera rices, choma, the native black pig from the Cordillera, imbukan rice, of course, katyos, kaypot, the sticky rice, Kamyas Artipa, Landan, which is the native tapioca, Luyang Tilaw, or yellow ginger. Is that the same as Tatawas? No? No? Different pa? Luyang Tilaw, right. Turmeric, right? So I think Talawak. I learned something new today. Okay, and then our suha, our pomelo from Tapao, is also an art of taste product. Tupok, which is a detox tea from the Ipatans in Batanes, that's also an art of taste product. Tawilis, the small fish from Taalay. the coffee that we saw earlier, criollo and marapo, and the pusong sili, which I think we also get sometimes here in Negros, and saging mundo. It's a strain of banana. Apart from that, our Visayan white corn. So there are 32. And according to Chip, after talking to Carlo Petrini, he wants to increase the number from the Philippines to 200. So I think this is the perfect venue to enjoy all of you in the effort to bring that list up. I think that we still can file our bangkiling. I know it appears in South America somewhere, but maybe we can file it and get credit for it. I think even our Kubat hasn't been filed yet. I think even Alumbati, which now we don't only use the gulay, thanks to Jejo Jimenez from Malipayon Farms, that we discovered also the pulak of the Alumbati and the temples, no? The sprout. So all of that, all those parts of the Alumbati, we're hoping we can find it. And even takwai, I think takwai hasn't been filed either. There's a dried up version in bananas that they call venus. Also, there's what they call in bananas uvin, which is not the ubat of the banana tree, but what they call banana corm. It's the root that grows under the soil. It's very hard. They shape it, and in bananas, they mix it with ground fish or ground meat, and they make it into like a tamales. So, let me take this opportunity then to join all of you to make a list, and perhaps you can submit it to the ladies and the gentlemen from Slow Food Negros so that we can find it and have a larger representation in the art of taste. We didn't have pictures of the... I think we have pictures because I want you to see how it appears in the booth.
Our country and our province with the wonderful produce. So that